Hello, I'm Dr. Whispers, and you're having trouble in your ear, is that correct? Which ear is it? Okay. Alright, I'm going to take a look and see, how long have you been having the issue? Oh, for a long while, okay. You should really come in, before, 2 weeks. You know, if you've been having it longer than 2 or 3 days, and it hasn't already cleared up, you should really come in and see us, but we'll get you checked out, okay? And I'm sure it's fine. We'll figure out what's going on with it, but I will need to just get some stuff ready over here, and then I'll give it a check, okay? I'll also be checking your other ear as well, okay? So hang on just a second, okay? Just a little bit of information, because we haven't seen you in a while, okay? I know the nurse got some information from you, but... Okay, you said it started a little over 2 weeks ago. Have you had any type of sinus drainage? You did at the time? Okay, fine. And can you hear out of it? Is the hearing muffled? It is, okay. Along with the pain. Okay. Okay. Let me try and just, we'll go ahead and just go ahead and get started. Let me get my gloves on here because I will be touching in your ear. I'm going to take my otoscope here, and I'm going to just have a look, okay? I'm going to check this ear first, so I just need you to hold real still for me, okay? And I'm going to be pulling your lobe down, okay? Alright, and then I'm going to also be pulling the outer part of your ear out. I'm going to check the other ear. I'm comparing the two as just an initial thing. Okay. Since you said, no, you haven't had any issue with this ear, is that correct? Okay, good. That's good. Sometimes if there is an infection, it can spread from one ear to the other. No pain or anything like that. Your lobe down so I can look further up into the ear. Okay. I'm gonna pull the top of your ear up and look down into the ear. Okay. Good. Okay. I'm not seeing just a whole lot of redness in the ear canal on your left side. They both look very similar. Both of them have a good bit of wax in them. It doesn't look impacted, though. So, what I'm going to do is just go ahead and remove wax out of both of them so I can get a clear look in both of them, and then maybe I can tell more about what's going on with the left ear. So, give me just a minute. I'm going to put some eardrops in. This is going to loosen and detach the wax from your ear. So, make it a lot easier to remove, and it's not going to hurt or anything. It's going to be kind of cold. So if you will, just hold still for me. I'm going to just drop and tilt your head for me like that. Thank you. There's one, two, three. Okay, now keep your head tilted that way. Now slowly tilt your head back, and I'm going to use this to catch any of the liquid that drains out of your ear so it doesn't get on your clothes. Okay. Okay, now let's do the other ear, because like I said, I'm going to remove the wax from both of them. Okay, tilt your head this way. That's one, two, three. Okay, keep your head tilted that way. Slowly to your head back. Okay, good. I'm gonna catch any residue that comes out. Okay, now that should be loosening the wax in both ears. And I am going to take a different light that I have here. This one that I attach to my hand. It's used to, can use that while I pick the wax out with one of these tools. Let me find the one I need. Okay. Here. So what I'm going to do is in just a minute I'm going to start to clean the wax out and get it ready. Okay, so I'm going to start with your right ear, and I'm going to use this little scoop here to remove any of the wax that loosened against the walls of your ear canal. So if I just need you to be real still for me. I will be very careful. I am not going very far back because the wax actually builds up more toward the front. So if you will just be real still for me, I'm going to remove this wax and then I'll remove it from the left side so I can get a better comparison of the two, okay? Right. So just hold real still for me. I need to compare the two here since this one's not hurting and I didn't see much of a difference. But you did have a buildup of wax and that needs to be removed anyway. So I'm going to use the other side of this that has the lasso side. Let me know if you feel any pain, but you shouldn't because there was also a little bit of a numbing agent in those drops. Okay. No pain. Thank you. Okay. I'm not going very far up in your ear because the wax isn't very far back. And I'm pulling your lid, your lobe down just a little bit. Side looks clean, and so does that one. So now I'm going to do another look with the otoscope to see if I can see what might actually be causing the I think that's what it's going to be because I don't see any redness or swelling on this side. However, so what I found is your eardrum on your left side, it does have a buildup of fluid, but it's not in the front part, meaning the part right after your ear canal. It's on the other side, which means where your eardrum is, it's swollen, but it's on the other side. Like it's not anything that can be drained out on this side. It actually is on the inner part. So what we'll probably need to do is get you on some antibiotics that will certainly take care of that, because when I'm looking at your right ear, it doesn't look like there's anything going on with it, and that would contribute to you not being able to hear as well, too. And then the pain as well. Sometimes with sinus infections, that can happen. I'm going to do another look. Let's see. Okay, continue to hold still for me. I just want to make sure that I'm not missing anything, because make sure I don't see any other reason. I mean, that's a very obvious reason, but I want to make sure it's not something else also that might be contributing to it, like some foreign object in your ear, but I don't see anything like that. And this ear looks, you know, completely clean, and like I said, the eardrum looks totally fine. Let me do something. Just look straight ahead at me. I'm going to take my hands and just kind of press right here. Start pressing kind of behind your ears. Okay. Do you feel any pain? You do on the left side a little bit, okay. But none on the right, okay. that's definitely what it is a built up there. Let me put, I've got a different set of drops over here that's got an antibiotic ointment. Now, like I said, this is on the other side of your eardrum. It's not on the side where your ear canal is, but it might be possible to get some of the infection if I do put some antibiotic drops in your ear right now. I'm not going to give you a prescription for this. I'm going to give you a prescription for some antibiotics that you take orally. But while you're here, I'm going to put some of this in your ear to see if it helps any. Turn your head sideways again for me. And once I put these in, please keep your head sideways for a minute. 2, 3. Just keep your head sideways for me. Think that's what's going to help it. It is very swollen. I really think maybe if you had come in sooner, it wouldn't be as swollen. But the antibiotics, once you start taking them orally, within 2 days, it's going to be a 10-day set of antibiotics. But after about the second day, you should start feeling a lot of relief, and you should be able, the pressure should be going down a lot more, and you should be able to feel, be able to hear a little bit better in your ear. Okay, so that is a very thick antibiotic. It shouldn't be coming out of your ear, so go ahead and turn your head back this way for me. I'll look one more time while the antibiotic's in there. Get this prescription filled, and if after you finish the prescription your ear does not, you can't completely feel, you don't feel any pain and there's no pressure and you can hear out of it normally just like you can out of your right ear, if it's not completely well after the 10 days of the antibiotic, make an appointment with us the very next day and we'll get you in to see what's going on with it or why it's not completely well. Okay. Just go to the front desk and check out.